So the complexity of the modules they're always increasing, and the space available, unfortunately, is always decreasing as more and more devices are added to the vehicle. So it's a balance of trying to put more and more in a smaller space, and that's a really big challenge. So there's new devices such as BGAs, they help reduce the board size, but they add challenges with regards to board layouts and manufacturing. And then depending on the ECU location, sealing and or conformal coating may be required as well. So all this needs to be accomplished at the best cost and lowest weight, as the automotive industry is extremely competitive. So engineers, they have several options for protecting their PCBAs from the harsh automotive environment. And there's a lot of science that goes into protecting these devices with many different forms of protection that can be used. So for example, boards could be placed in a housing sealed with silicone or some other adhesive. It could be coated with traditional conformal coating, such as a silicone, epoxy, a urethane, or UV-cured acrylate. They could even be potted with a resin, or you could use a next-generation thin film solution. All of these methods have a place. However, seals can break over time. Covering the PCBA with traditional conformal coatings, like epoxies and silicones, they add weight. They're not very even. They can trap heat, and they can also stress sensitive components like BGAs. So with thin film coatings, such as perylene, weight addition is minimized as coatings are generally less than 50 microns thick. Perylene has excellent thermal and dielectric properties. And also, since perylene is applied through a chemical vapor deposition process, it truly is 3D conformal. All the edges of the components and PCB, they're all coated evenly, can even get underneath components as well.